Welcome to Edupedia World. In this video, we will discuss about median and how it is computed. Positional averages. In the previous chapter, we discussed the concept of simple arithmetic mean and weighted mean, which are mathematical in nature. Such mathematical averages deal with those characteristics of a data set which can be directly measured quantitatively. However, at times, we need to measure qualitative characteristics of a distribution. In such cases, the other measures of the central tendency are positional averages. Positional averages determines the position of variable in the series. The positional averages have nothing to do with the sum of the values of the variable. As a result, they are least affected by the extreme items of the series. The various positional averages are shown in the following chart. As you can see that positional averages are of three kinds, that is median, partition value and mode. Partition value is further divided into three segments, that is quartile, decile and percentile. However, the present chapter focuses only on median and mode in accordance with the CBSE syllabus. A brief reference of quartiles is also given as its knowledge is important to understand the concept of quartile deviation. We will discuss all these things in the coming slides. Median. The arithmetic mean is affected by the presence of extreme values in the data. If you take a measure of central tendency which is based on middle position of the data, it is not affected by extreme items. Median is that positional value of the variable which divides the distribution into two equal parts. One part comprises all values greater than or equal to the median value, and the other comprises all values less than or equal to it. The median is the middle element when the data set is arranged in order of the magnitude. For example, suppose weight of 5 person is 55, 62, 60, 59, 70 kg respectively. Now to calculate the value of median, the first step is to arrange the data in the ascending or descending order. Arranging the weight in ascending order, we get 55, 59, 60, 62, 70. So the median value is 60 kg as it occupies the middle position. If there are even numbers in the data, there will be two observations which fall in the middle. The median in this case is computed as the arithmetic mean average of the two middle values. Median is a positional average as its value is ascertained on the basis of its position in the series. Median divides a series into two equal parts. Median value concentrates in the center of distribution. Median is denoted by letter M. Definitions. Median may be defined as the middle value in the data set when its elements are arranged in a sequential order, that is in either ascending or descending order of magnitude. According to Tate, median is that point on the scale of score below which one half of the score lies and above which one half of the score lies. One more definition will clear the point about the median, that is according to Connor. Median is that value of the variable which divides the group into two equal parts. One part comprising all values greater than the median value and the other part comprising all the values smaller than the median value. Next, we come to computation of median. The median can be calculated in the following series, that is individual series, discrete series and continuous series. We will study calculation of median in these three series in detail in the next slides. Calculation of median in individual series or ungrouped data. In individual series, there is no frequency as it is an ungrouped data. Only values of the variables are given. In other words, only X is given in these series. First of all, data are arranged in ascending order or descending order. After that, we use the following formula to calculate median, that is M is equal to size of N plus 1 divided by 2 item, where M stands for median and N stands for number of items. If given set of data consists of odd numbers of items, then the middle item of the set is known as median. For example, You have to find out the median from the following data on income of some employees, that is 130, 185, 170, 900 and so on. So first, we will arrange the data in ascending order. As you can see in the table, we have arranged the data in the ascending order, that is we have started from 130, 170, 185 and so on till 900. Here n is equals to 9. N stands for number of observations. As from the previous table, we can see that in this particular example, number of observations are 9. After that, we will write the formula of median. M is equals to size of n plus 1 divided by 2 item. In place of n, we will write 9. After calculating it, we will get size of 5th item. As we have already seen in the table before that, in place of 5th item, we have written 380 when we have arranged the data in ascending order. So for this particular example, median of a given data is rupees 380. This is how we will calculate median in individual series when the given set of data consists of odd number of items. Next we come to even numbers. If given set of data consists of even number of items, then average of two middle items is known as median. For example, we have to calculate the median age of 8 students, that is 21, 18, 19, 14 and so on. So let's start with solution. First we have to arrange the data in ascending order. As you can see in the table, in the first row we have written the serial number, that is 1 to 8, and in the second row we have written age in ascending order. After making the table, we can see that number of observation in this particular illustration is 8. So n is equals to 8. Now we will apply the formula of median. M is equals to size of n plus 1 divided by 2 item. In place of n, we will write 8. After calculating it, we will get size of 4.5th item. Now we will add the size of 4th item and 5th item and then divide it by 2. Size of 4th item is 14 and size of 5th item is 18. So we will add 14 plus 18 divided by 2. We will get 16 years. So median age for this particular illustration is 16 years. This is how we will calculate median when the set of data consists of even numbers. Next we come to calculation of median in discrete series or grouped data. In discrete series, there is frequency given against the definite value of the variable. In simple words, there are variable x and corresponding frequencies f given in discrete series. To calculate median, first of all, frequency distribution is arranged in ascending or descending order. Letter X denotes variable and letter F denotes frequency. Cumulative frequency, which is CF, are calculated. After that, we use the following formula to calculate median, which is M is equals to size of N plus 1 divided by 2 item. Here M is equals to median and N is equals to number of items or total of frequency. The size is located in the value of variable X against the cumulative frequency in which n plus 1 divided by 2 falls. This we will discuss with the help of a particular illustration in the next slide. In this particular illustration, we have to calculate median from the following data. The data is given, that is size, which is denoted by letter X, and frequency is given. First, we will make the table of three columns. In the first column, we will write size, which is denoted by letter X. In this, we will write 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. In the second column, we will write frequency, which is denoted by letter F. In this, we will write the frequency, which is already given in the question, that is 4, 1, 3, 7, 4. In the third column, we will write the cumulative frequency, means we will add up the frequency. We will start with 4. Then after that, we will add 1 to it, we will get 5. Then we will add 3 to it, we will get 8. Then we will add 7 to it, we will get 15. And after that, we will add 4 to it, we will get 90. This is how we'll make the table. After making up the table, we can see that number of observation is 90. So n is equals to 90. Now we'll apply the formula of median, which is m is equals to size of n plus 1 divided by 2 item. In place of n, we will write 19. And after calculating, it will get size of 10th item. Since 10 items fall in cumulative frequency 15 and the size variable against the cumulative frequency is 8, therefore median of the series is equals to 8. This is how we will calculate median in discrete series. Next, we come to calculation of median in continuous series. In continuous series, there is frequency given against the class intervals of the variables. In simple words, there are variables x and frequency f given continuous series, x being given in the form of class intervals. Next, to calculate median, first of all, frequency distribution is arranged in ascending or descending order. X denotes variable and f denotes frequency. Next, we'll calculate cumulative frequency, which is denoted by CF. After that, we will use the following formula to find median class, which is M is equals to size of N by 2 item. Here, M is equals to median and N is equals to total frequency. Median class is located in the size of variables X, in whose cumulative frequency the size of N by 2 items fall. We apply the following formula to find exact value of median from the median class intervals. M is equals to L1 plus N by 2 minus CF whole divided by F multiplied by I. Here M is equals to median. L1 stands for lower limit of the median class. CF stands for cumulative frequency of the class preceding the median class. F stands for frequency of the median class. And I stands for size of the median class intervals. We will understand this with the help of illustration in the coming slide. In this particular illustration, we have to find out the median for the following data. As you can see that marks and number of students are given. Marks is given in the form of class intervals, that is 0 to 10, 10 to 20 and so on. And number of students are the frequency for this particular illustration. So we'll start with the solution. First, we'll make the table of three column. In the first column, we'll write the marks, which is denoted by letter X. We will write 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40 and 40 to 50. In the second column, we'll write the number of students, which is denoted by letter F, which is frequency. We will write the frequency as given in the question, that is 3, 4, 2, 7, 10. We will get sigma F is equals to 26. In the last column, we'll write the cumulative frequency. As we know, cumulative frequency is the add-on of frequency. We'll start with 3. After that, we'll add 4 to 3, we'll get 7. Next, we'll add 2 to 7, we'll get 9 and so on. This is how we'll make the table for this particular illustration. After making the table, we can see that number of observation, which is N, is equals to 26. Now we will apply the formula of median, that is M is equals to size of N by 2 item. In place of N, we will write 26. After dividing 26 by 2, we'll get size of 13th item. Size of 13th item lies in the group of 30 to 40. Hence, median class is 30 to 40. Now, L1, which is lower limit of class intervals, equals to 30. CF, which is cumulative frequency of median class 30 to 40, is 9. F, which is frequency of median class 30 to 40, is equals to 7. And I, which is the class interval, is equals to 10. Now we'll apply the formula of median, that is L1 plus N by 2 minus CF whole divided by F into I. We will write the particular values that we have written and we'll calculate it. We'll get median is equals to 35.71. This is how we'll calculate median in continuous series. Thank you for watching Edupedia World videos.